Hey, what's going on, y'all? It's your girl Kira, and today I have a two-way inside-out scoreboard that has a 99 driving dunk to show you guys in NBA 2K23. Now, before I show you guys the build, hit that like button for your girl, subscribe if you are new, and turn on post notifications. And also follow me on all my socials. Links will be down in the description below. So let's get right into the video. So I went with shooting guard, but you guys can go with point guard or small forward. Right, left hand is your preference, and your jersey number is also your preference. I went 6'9". Now, the only reason I did that is because it's late in the game. You know, 2K24 come out in about 3 months or so. And so it's just easier to get those badges at the 6'9 height. You can go 6'8", especially because you can get that, I think, 85 3-point shot or the 89 ball handle. A lot of people have also gone 6'8" using the 99 driving dunk build, but I like this better suited at 6'9", solely for the fact that it's June. And don't nobody have all the time in the world to grind badges. It's just easier to get badges at the 6'9 height for this type of build. Now, if you would have made this earlier in the year, then that's fine. You could have made it at 6'8", but I didn't do it that way because I feel like this was better. So moving on, enough of that ranking. Weight, 185 pounds, wingspan, 7'6", body shape, I went with define, but you guys go with whatever you like. Now for the attributes, 70 close shot, 80 driving layup, the 99 driving dunk, and the 70 standing dunk. Right there. So we get posterized, of course, on Hall of Fame, limitless takeoff, area wizard, slithering on Hall of Fame. And that's the reason why I went 6'9", because you know, if you go 6'8", limitless takeoff, take slithery, all of them are tier 3. And this late in the game, y'all, you don't want to be coring all those badges to get other badges. It's just not worth it. Okay, so you'll be able to get those badges because they're in lower tiers, so you'll be all straight. Now for shooting, got 74 mid-range, 83 3-point shot, and a 70 free throw for those who like to play in the rack. So you do get catch and shoot on goal, which would be good for you if you want to put that on. Dead eye, blinders, green machine, guard of y'all has been working a lot lately. I've been using it on a lot of my builds, and it has been popping up like crazy and activating. So try that badge out if you have, you know, given up on it in, you know, the past few weeks. Plus you get agent 3 on silver. You got amps, mini magicians. We got a good shooting badges for this build. Now for playmaking, you got a 75 pass accuracy, an 87 ball handle, so you get the go with first up, and you got the 75 speed with ball, so you get the MJ dribble style. And as you guys can see, you get unpluggable, you know, handles for days. You bail out on bronze, that's all you need. Hyperdrive, so we got a good playmaking badge that you see right there. Now for defensive rebound, I got a 68 interior, 87 perimeter, 85 steal, 88 block, and the 42 defensive rebound. That's just there. You will be mostly playing the point guard position with this build or the primary ball handler. So that's how I made it anyways. But of course, if you play with other people or people that you know, like, you won't have to worry about getting a defensive rebound because your teammates will be able to get them for you. But you have the 87 perimeter D so that you can get that minutes on Hall of Fame. If you don't care about that, just bring it down to 86. You still have the silver clamps, 85 steal for the silver glove, 88 block for the Hall of Fame chase down artist, as you see right there. So we got all the good decent defensive rebounding badges for this build. And then for your physicals, you got that 80 speed, 81 acceleration, 43 strength, 82 vertical, and the 90 stamina right there. So you got 18 finishing, 19 shooting, 20 playmaking, and 16 defensive badges on this build. And I went with double finishing moves, but you guys can go with whatever you like. You get shot creating, sharp, and you get, of course, lock take on this build. And you have built a two-way inside out score, so let me show the badges that I put on the build. Okay, so with finishing, I would do limitless takeoff. Now you guys only need this, y'all, on silver. You can put it up as high as you want to, but it works just fine on silver. So if you want to save, you know, some badge points, then just put it on silver. I'm telling you, you'll be fine. Okay, so I'm putting it on silver. I love area wizard. That has been my go-to badge lately for putbacks, but you guys don't have to put that on if you don't want to. Definitely you need slithery, so I would throw that on. And then I just, let me see, do like two right here, so I can come down here. But you guys want to core posterizer, you guys can put on this, you can put on this, but it's not needed. So I will come back up here again. You can put this up to Hall of Fame if you like. Take off pro touch. I love area wizard, so I'll probably put that on. But you probably can do like put on fearless if you want to, and then you can do this right here and you be all straight. You know, it's however you want to put it, but I prefer to run limit take off on silver so I can put those extra badge points somewhere else. But you guys can do whatever you want, but for the sake of this video, I'm gonna leave it like this. Now for shooting, it all depends on how you guys play. How I play, I'm more of a catch and shoot type of girl, and when I do get the ball, especially with this type of build, I'm going right to the basket. But if you are not like me and you do a lot of dribbling, I would do definitely green machine. You need your agent 3, and then put this one up here for now. You got blind, you got the catch and shoot, you got the dead eye. Of course you don't have that, so you guys put on whatever you want. I would probably do, if it was me, I would core catch and shoot. Super easy to core. I prefer dead eye over blinders, but if you are going to be the primary ball handle, you will definitely need blinders. So definitely put that on, and you have 3 left. Definitely put on amped, silver or gold, it does not matter. But if you do that, you get only have 1 left, so you have to throw that on somewhere. So what I'll probably do is drop that down, and if you want to, you know, be a spot up type shooter, just put claymore, you can put that on silver, you can do something like this. But definitely you will need green machine, agent 3, you know, blinders, amped, you know, things of that nature. If you guys want to run that guard up, like I said, it's starting to work. work and pop up and activate a little bit more, so you can throw that on as well. Now for playmaking, definitely bailout for me. A lot of people don't use it, but I need it. Quick first step, put the hyperdrive on silver. All you need is on silver, you guys. If you want to put up on gold, that's fine, but silver is all you really need. Then I'll come down here, probably core clan breaker, handles for days, and you guys need an unpluggable. So if you guys want to like uncore, maybe uncore this and don't use that and put unpluggable on, let me take this off, do that. You only have three left, so you can't even get handles for days. So you have to add extra badge points to this category. So it all depends on how you guys play. How I play, I don't need unpluggable because I don't do a lot of dribbling, but this particular build requires you, or you at least be able to dribble. So at least, you know, put this unpluggable on silver or whatever the case may be. And then when you get some extra badge points from my career, or if you hit level 39, just add them on here so that you can get the handles for days on silver. You guys can do it that way. It's all in whatever you want and however, you know, you guys play this game. But I'm just adding right here for the sake of this video. Now for defense, I don't use challenger at all. I'll probably do chase down artist, and then I'll probably do clamps, of course. And then you have this down here. I'll pour anchor and put on glove, and then I will do probably workhorse because I like that. But you can put on interceptor as well. That's a really good badge to put on, but I'll probably do workhorse and I will leave it just like this. Okay, but again, it's all in however you guys play, and if you're playing by yourself or with your squad or whatever the case may be. But hey, thank you guys so much for watching. If you're still here and you enjoyed it, make sure you drop a like, subscribe if you are new, and turn on post notifications so you'll know when I post all these new bangers. And also watch these two videos right here, and I'm out. Peace.